ஆழ்வார் எம்பெருமானார் ஜியர் திருவடிகளை சரணம், ஜியர் திருவடிகளை சரணம். வி ஆர் என்ஜாயிங் தி மீனிங்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஸ்ரீ பகவத்கீதா. பகவத் ராமானுஜர் ஹாஸ் கிவன் அ பியூட்டிஃபுல் காமெண்ட்ரி இன் தி ஃபார்ம் ஆஃப் கீதா பாஷ்யம் ஃபார் பகவத்கீதா. வேதாந்தாச்சாரிய வேதாந்த தேசிகர் ஆல்சோ ஹாஸ் கிவன் தாத்பரிய சந்திரிகை, விச் இஸ் அன் எலாபரேட் எக்ஸ்பிளனேஷன் ஃபார் கீதா ஸ்லோகம்ஸ். புத்தூர் ஸ்ரீ உவே கிருஷ்ணசுவாமி ஐயங்கார் ஹஸ் கிவன் அ தமிழ் காமெண்ட்ரி பேஸ்ட் ஆன் தீஸ் அவைலபிள் பூர்வாச்சாரிய வியாக்கியானம்ஸ். ஆஸ் பார்ட் ஆஃப் தட் எலாபரேட் தமிழ் காமெண்ட்ரி, புத்தூர் சுவாமி ஹஸ் கிவன் வேர்ட் பை வேர்ட் மீனிங்ஸ் ஃபார் ஆல் தி ஸ்லோகம்ஸ். வி ஆர் சீயிங் தி மீனிங்ஸ் ஆஃப் all the Gita Shlokams using this word by word meanings given by Puthu Swami with the English translation is already available with us in our website. We have completed 6 chapters and we are now in the 7th chapter. This chapter is known as Paramahamsa Vijnana Yoga. In this adhyayam, in this chapter, Krishna is explaining about his own nature, the types of people who come and approach him, who surrender unto him, and those who move away from him, do not surrender unto him. So we have seen up to the 23rd shlokam. In the last 4 shlokams, he explained about those who worship other devatas, how he is the antaryami of all the other devatas, how he is the bestower of all the results for the worship of the devotees of other devatas. But these devotees of other devatas, they don't understand that Bhagavan is the antaryami of all these devatas and all the results are given by Bhagavan only. They are only seeing the devatas and worshipping them without deeper understanding. Now from this 24th shlokam, in 4 shlokams, Bhagavan continues to explain those who are confused and who are less intelligent because they have not understood the true nature of Bhagavan. We will see one by one, one shlokam at a time. 24th shlokam. Avyaktam vyaktimapannam manyante mam abuddhayaha parambhavam ajananto mamavyayam anuttamam. In this shlokam, Bhagavan is explaining that jivatmas who are unwise, who are bound in this world, are thinking that Krishna is just a superhuman with extraordinary powers and he has gotten all these powers due to his past karma, past virtues. They don't understand the superior nature of Bhagavan who has taken this incarnation out of compassion towards all the jivatmas. Let us see the word by word meaning. Abuddhaya, most jivatmas who are unwise, avyayam, imperishable, anuttamam, highest, without any match, mama, parambhavam, my superior nature, ajanantam, without knowing, mam, me, avyaktam, not existing like this before, vyaktim apannam, taken birth like this due to my past virtues. Manyante, think about me. So Krishna is saying, most jivatmas who are unwise, without knowing my imperishable, highest and superior nature, think about me as not existing like this before and as having taken birth now like this due to my past virtues. They simply think that due to past virtues, I have taken a birth where I have superior powers, supernatural powers. Krishna is well known to have exhibited such supernatural powers like killing the demons, leading the Mahabharata battle war, wielding the chakra in his hand. So these are all beyond human capacity. So people observe all of this, but due to their inferior knowledge, they just think that Krishna acquired these powers by his own virtues. They don't understand that Bhagavan is superior. He is Supreme Lord himself who has taken this incarnation out of compassion to everyone, towards everyone. 25th shlokam. Naham prakashah sarvasya yogamaya samavratah. Mudoyam nabijanati loko mam ajamavyayam. Yogamaya samavratah aham. I who have assumed a human form covered by maya. Maya is amazing ability. So Bhagavan has taken this human form. He is concealing all of his abilities and not manifesting them all at the same time. Sarvasya, for most people in this world, na prakashaha, not shining. So most people in this world, even during Krishna's times, they were all able to see Bhagavan's some specialities, some powers. But they were not able to understand his greatness, and they were all not seeing his greatness. For example, Akrura was able to understand, recognize Bhagavan as Krishna as supreme. Vidura was able to acknowledge and recognize Krishna as supreme. Pandavas were able to recognize him, but others were not able to recognize him. Similarly, in Ramavataram, there was Hanuman who was able to see that Bhagavan has come as Sri Rama. As soon as Hanuman sees Sri Rama in Kishkinda, he was able to understand that, because he was seeking for Brahman. He was seeking for that Supreme Lord. He was searching for that. But those who have no interest will not see Bhagavan even when he is present right in front of them. That is explained in this shlokam. Mudaha ayam lokaha. Ignorant people of this world. Mam, me, ajam, as the cause who does not have birth. So Bhagavan does not have any birth like us. We are taking birth based on our karma. But Bhagavan is taking birth based on his desire, his own ichcha, his compassion towards others, his kripa. So he is said as ajan. Aja means one who does not have birth. So he does not have birth like us who have taken birth out of karma, but he takes birth out of his desire. Abhyayam, the imperishable Sarveshwara, na abhijanan, abhijana, abhijanati. Abhijanati. That means they don't analyze and know me as such, that I am the supreme. So that is lacking in the jivatmas, because they don't seek Bhagavan, they are not in search of Bhagavan, and they have less intelligence. Hence, they are not seeing the divinity in Krishna, in Bhagavan. That is explained in this shlokam. So he has assumed a human body, human form, and his powers are concealed to some extent. They are only revealed at times, and hence he is not shining for most people as the Supreme Lord. But there are those who are very devoted towards him. They recognize him, they understand his glory, and they acknowledge, they understand that this is Bhagavan who is unborn, who does not have any birth. He is the cause of everyone, but now he has taken birth for us. He is imperishable, he is Sarveshwara. They understand that. But most people who are less intelligent, they don't understand it. Says Krishna in this shlokam. 26th shlokam. Vedaham samitani vartamanani charjuna bhavishyani cha bhutani mamtu veda na kaschana. In this shlokam, Krishna is saying that he knows all the jivatmas, bound souls, whether they were in the past, they are in the present, or in the future. So many jivas have bodies now. There will be other jivas who will have bodies in future, and there were jivas before. So he knows all of them, but others, all of these jivatmas, these bound souls, they don't understand me, says Krishna in this shlokam. Arjuna, O Arjuna, samatitani, of the past, vartamani, of the present, bhavishyani cha, of the future, bhutani, all bound souls, bhuta means that which exists, all the souls which are existing in this material world, aham, I, veda, no, mam tu, but me, kashchana, not even one person among all of these, na veda, they don't truly know. All of these bound souls, they don't understand me because they are bound in this world, they are covered by ignorance and they are lacking intelligence through which they can understand me. That is 26th shlokam. Now we will see 27th shlokam. Icha dvesha samuttena dvandva mohena bharata sarva bhutani sammoham sargeyanti parantapa. O descendant of Bharata, Bharata. So here Krishna is calling Arjuna as Bharata, descendant of Bharata. Parantapa, O torturer of enemies. He is so valorous that he will torture his enemies. Arjuna, that is. Icha dvesha samuttena, caused by liking towards some aspects and hatred towards some aspects in worldly matters. Because everything is material in this world. Those who are ignorant also see everything in this material vision only. They see that they like some objects, some aspects, and they hate some aspects. Dvandva mohena, bewildering, selfish experiences such as happiness and sorrow. There is duality everywhere in this material world, heat and cold, happiness and sorrow. So there is this duality, and because of this duality, sarva bhutani, all bound souls, sarge, even while taking birth, sammoham yanti, attain great bewilderment. Even while taking birth, they come with great bewilderment, great confusion. Because there is past karma, there is vasana, impressions, and then ruchi, the taste from previous births. Because of all of this, when they take birth itself, they have ignorance in them, they have bewilderment in them. And because of all of this, they have this duality, vision of duality, happiness and sorrow, cold and heat, and so on. Hence, they are not able to see me, explains Krishna in this shlokam. By these four shlokams, Krishna is, by these eight shlokams actually, Krishna is explaining how the worshippers of other devatas and how the materialistic people, they are all fully engaged in worldly affairs, worldly activities, and by explaining this, he is explaining the greatness of Jnani, who is fully devoted to Bhagavan. Because we have seen about Jnani previously that he is very dear to Bhagavan, and Bhagavan is, Krishna is explaining that greatness by highlighting the inferior nature of the other souls. 28th shlokam. Yesham twanta gatam papam jananam punyakarmanam te dvandva moha nirmuktaha bhajante mam dridavrataha punyakarmanam yesham tu jananam. Those souls who have performed abundance of virtuous acts, papam antagatam, when their sins, explained in the previous shlokam, come to an end, they, such people, dvandva moha nirmuktaha, being slowly relieved from the bewilderment of twin effects such as happiness and sorrow according to their virtues, dridavrataha, with firm vow to attain worldly wealth, self-enjoyment or service to Bhagavan according to their virtues, mam bhajante, start worshipping me to attain those results. So in this shlokam, Krishna is explaining Assuming Arjuna is asking a question. Because in the last 8 shlokas, Krishna explained that those who have less intelligent, they worship other devatas, they are engaged in material enjoyment only. Now Krishna is explained all of this. Arjuna is asking, if that is the case, how the 4 types of people, that is Artha, Artharthi, Jignasu and Jnani, all these 4 types of people develop attachment towards you? How do they surrender unto you? How do they come to you? That is the question which Krishna is assuming that Arjuna is asking. For that Krishna is answering in this shlokam. He is saying that those souls who have performed abundance of virtuous acts, many punyam has been done by these souls, and because of their punyam and their inclination towards dharmam, their sins slowly reduce and they come to an end. And once their sins reduce, they will be relieved from this duality of hatred and happiness and joy and sorrow and so on. And with firm vow, they will come to Bhagavan and then they will start praying to Bhagavan for whatever they desire. Aishwaryarthi will pray for wealth, Kaivalyarthi will pray for Kaivalyam or self-enjoyment, and Bhagavad Prapti Nishtha will ask for service to Bhagavan. These also depend on their own karma. If someone has lot of karma, punya karma, then they will be Aishwaryarthi. If someone has even more punya karma, then they will be Kaivalyarthi. And even more punya karma, if someone has even more punya karma, they will be fully attached to Bhagavan. So it is a gradual development of engaging in punya karma and developing attachment in dharma and Bhagavan, and slowly one will progress. That is explained in this particular shlokam. That is 28th shlokam. Now we will see 29th shlokam. Now these two, 29 and 30, are the last two shlokams of this adhyayam. In these two shlokams, Krishna is explaining what is required to be known for Aishwaryarthi, Kaivalyarthi and Bhagavad Prapti Nishtha. In the first shlokam, he mainly explains, that is in the 29th shlokam, he mainly explains what is to be known by Kaivalyarthi. And in the second shlokam, in the 30th shlokam, he explains what is to be known by the Aishwaryarthi. But all these aspects are equally important for one who is fully dedicated to Bhagavan and one who wants to just do Kaikeyam for Bhagavan. 29th shlokam. Jara marana mokshaya mam ashritya yatantiye te brahma tadviduhu kritsnam adhyatmam karma chakilam. Jara marana mokshaya, to attain atmanubhava rupa moksham, the liberation of self-enjoyment after being relieved from 6 aspects of existence such as old age, death, etc., and eliminating the trace of connection to prakriti, materialistic nature. So jara marana mokshaya is clearly focusing on kaivalya nishtha, because for kaivalya nishtha the only aim is to be relieved from worldly attachment and this material world. He doesn't desire any other thing. He is only looking at being relieved from this worldly environment and fully situated in Atma and enjoying the Atma. That is his only goal. So he is looking at being relieved from the 6 types of changes, transformations, that is existence, taking birth, growing and then reducing and then dying and so on. These 6 aspects are common for all entities, and this Kaivalyarthi, they don't want to be engaged in these 6 aspects. So he is fully looking to be freed from this and the connection with Prakriti. That is what is explained in this Jara Marana Mokshaya. Mam Ashritya, approaching me. To be relieved of that, one has to approach Bhagavan. Ye Yatanti, those who try, te, them, Tad Brahma, that which is known as Brahma, Kritsnam, Adhyatmam, and completely that which is known as Adhyatma, Akilam Karmacha, and all those which are known as Karma, Viduhu, have to know. So these Kaivalyarthis, they have to know what is Brahmam, what is Adhyatmam, and then what is Karma. Only when they have full knowledge about all these three, they will be able to attain this Kaivalya Moksham, explains Krishna. Here Brahma is Bhagavan himself, Adhyatma is true knowledge about the self, and Karma is how one should act and how the reactions of actions will be. So only when one has a holistic idea about all these three, they will be able to progress towards Kaivalya Moksham. That is explained in this 29th shlokam, the final shlokam of this adhyayam. Sadhi Bhuta Didaivam Mam Sadhi Yajnam Cha Ye Viduhu Prayana Kalepi Cha Mam Te Vidur Yukta Chetasaha. In this shlokam, he is specifically addressing Aishwaryatis, those who are seeking material wealth. But both these shlokams have content for those who are interested in performing Kaikaryam to Bhagavan, those who are identified as Jnanis also. Ye Aishwaryatis, those who desire worldly wealth, Sa Adibhuta Adidaivam, with the qualities of Adibhuta and Adidaiva. These are explained elaborately in 8th chapter, next chapter by Krishna. So we'll see in detail about these concepts there. Mam, me, Viduhu, should know. So here he is saying that Aishwaryarthis should know my aspect of being the Adibhuta and Adidaivam. How I am having the qualities of Adibhuta and Adidaivam. Mam, Viduhu. So he says, they should know about me, about this aspect. Sa Adi Yajnam Cha Viduhu. Like the two others, Kaivalyarthis, those who desire self-enjoyment, and Bhagavat Kaikaryarthis, all of those as well, should know me as the one with the quality of Adi Yajna, that I am the master of Yajna, I am the master of Yagams, that should be known by all of these entities. But mainly Aishwaryarthis should know this. Techa, these three types of people who are engaged in me to fulfill their desire, Prayana Kale Api, while shedding their bodies to attain their desired goal at the time of death. So at the time of death, when they shed their body, when they are going towards their goal, at that time, Yukta Chetasaha, remembering me according to their desired goal. This is called as Antima Smriti. Depending on one's last minute, that last moment thinking, one will attain whatever one desires, depending on their karma also. Mam Viduhu, should know. So remembering me, they should remember me at the end of their life, whatever goal they desire for, which they have worked for at the end of their life, and they should think about that, says Krishna in this shlokam. So with this, Krishna has explained in this chapter, in this adhyayam, the various types of, the four types of people who approach him, the four types of people who do not approach him, the worshippers of other devatas, those who are materially minded. All of these were explained by Krishna. And in the end, he explained what is to be known by those Kaivalyarthis, Aishwaryarthis and Bhagavat Prapti Nishtas, all of them. In the next session, we will start the 8th chapter's explanation. Alvar Emperumanar G.R. Thiruvadigalai Sharanam, G.R. Thiruvadigalai Sharanam.
To learn such valuable information about our Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya, please download Koyil KOYIL app from Google Play Store or Apple App Store. Our website is koyil.org, KOYIL.org.